using the Laplace transform to solve the initial value problem y triple prime plus 2y double prime minus y prime minus 2y equals sin3t, and you are given y of 0 equals 0, y prime of 0 equals 0, y double prime of 0 equals 1. By the transform of a derivative theorem, we have for this one s cubed times capital Y of s. So you must start with s to the derivative times capital Y of s and subtract out to s to the 0 minus s to the second times y of 0 minus s to the first times y prime of 0 minus s to the 0 times y double prime of 0. So this is for what we have for y triple prime. Now for y to y double prime, we are going to use, we are going to do the same thing, but don't forget to distribute the 2 as you go along. So you have y double prime, that means that we have 2s squared times capital Y of s, so always times capital Y of s for the first term, and then subtract out until you reach s to 0, minus 2 times s, y of 0, minus 2 times s to the 0, y prime of 0. Okay? Now for this one, let me write it down here because I don't have enough space up here. Negative y prime. So you have negative s to the first times capital Y of s minus minus becomes plus s to the 0 times y of 0. Okay? And for the last one, minus 2 times, since you don't have any derivative, that means that we have s to the 0 times capital Y of s is equal to the Laplace transform of sin3t is equal to 3 over s squared plus 9. Okay? Now, we are going to take a look at capital Y of s terms. Those are what I already circled. Let me draw a line to separate the steps here. And let's factor out capital Y of s. Then in parentheses, I have s cubed plus 2s squared minus s minus 2 times capital Y of s equals 3 over s squared plus 9. Okay, and hold on, I'm not done yet. So you have a y of 0 equals 0. So this goes away. Y prime of 0 equals 0. This goes away. Minus y double prime of 0 and y double prime of 0 equals 1. So you have negative 1 on the left side. Move it to the right side, which is positive 1. And for this one, y of 0 equals 0. So this goes away. Y prime of 0 equals 0. This goes away. Y of 0 equals 0. This goes away. Right? So this is all we have. Now I'm going to divide both sides by this to get y capital Y of s itself. So on the left side, I have s capital Y of s. On the right side, I have 3 over s squared plus 9 times s cubed. Oh, by the way, let me combine this. So the LCD is s squared plus 9. So first, the LCD is squared plus 9. For this one, we have 3. For this one, multiply this by s squared plus 9. So add these together, we have 3 s squared plus 12 on the numerator. And on the denominator, we have, and on the denominator, we have s squared plus 9 times s cubed plus 2 s squared minus s minus 2. Okay? Now, I'm going to break this down into factors. So, on the top, just rewrite it. On the bottom, let's rewrite this. And for this one, as you can see, we have I'm going to factor out negative 1. So, for I'm going to loop and the first 2 and the last 2. So, the first 2, I have factor out s squared. I left with s plus 2. Factor out negative 1. Then, in parentheses, I left with s plus 2. Okay? Now, for this one, because they both of these has s plus 2 in common to factor it out. And we left with s squared minus 1. So s squared minus 1 can be worked down to s plus 1 times s minus 1 because it's a difference of square. Now we are going to use the partial fraction decomposition method to find the single fractions of this. So this can be obtained from a over from as plus b over s squared plus 9 plus c over s plus 2 plus d over s plus 1 plus e over s minus 1. So while all these has just c, it's just a constant, but this has as times b as plus b over s squared plus 9. Well, because this is an irreducible quadratic, so you have to obtain for every single term that is less than s squared. with r as the first and s as 0, because we don't know what a is. So a could be 0, that means that we have only a constant on the top, but it could be a non-zero number. So we have to account for every possibility, okay? Now, the LCD is everything on the denominator. So multiply by the LCD on both sides. I get s squared plus 12 equals as plus b times s plus 2 times s plus 1 times s minus 1 plus c times s squared plus 9 times s plus 1 times s minus 1 plus b times s squared plus 9 times s plus 2 times s minus 1 plus e times s squared plus 9 times s plus 2 times s plus 1. Okay? Now I'm going to take a limit at s approach is negative 2. On the left side, I have negative 2 squared 14 plus 16. On the right side, as s approaches negative 12, it eliminates this. It eliminates this and this, so I left with this. So negative 2 squared 4, 9, 4, 13, 13, negative 1, negative 13. So negative 13 c. Then c equals. Oh, bad. So you have 4, 2, negative 2 squared 4, 4, 9, plus 9, 13, 13 times negative 1, negative 13 times negative 3, which is 39. C. Then C equals 16 over 39. Take a limit as S approach, as S approaches negative 1. On the left side, I have 13. On the right side, as S approaches negative 1, it eliminates this. This and this, so we're left with this. Negative 1 squared, which is 1 plus 9, 10. 10 times 3, 30. 30, negative 2, negative 30, negative 2, negative 60. 10 more. Yeah, negative 60. Now let me check it. It happens again. So you have negative 1 squared, which is 1 plus 9, 10. 10 times 1, which is 10. 10 times negative 2, which is negative 20. 20, negative 20d, then d equals negative 13 over 20. Okay, I have to watch carefully with algebra here. Take a limit as s approaches 1. On the left side, I have 13. On the right side, it eliminates this, this, and this, so we're left with this. 1 squared plus 9, 10. 10 times 3, 30. 30 times 2, 60. E. Then e equals 13 over 60. Okay, so I think that's all I can find using the limits. Now, there's no more terms we can use the limits, so we have to fall back using equating coefficients. So let's take a look at the leading coefficient of s to the 4th, which is the highest exponent. On the left side, we have 0. On the right side, it was not to multiply these out, but if you cannot see it, you can multiply it out, it's up to you. So s to the 4th, you see you have as times s times s times s. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, so you have a. Right? Move to this one. We have, let's see, SSSC, A plus C, plus D, plus E. So you know C, you know D, you know E, then you can find A. So let me use a calculator here because there's a bunch of fractions here and I don't want to mess up with it. So I have C equals 16 over 39 plus negative 13 over 20. Plus 13 over 60 is equal to negative 3 over 130. So A has to be 3 over 130. Okay, now let's take a look at the leading coefficient of S to the 0. Because I have A, C, D, and I need to find B. 0 can work with S to the 3rd power, but it's up to you. You can work with whatever order you like. Okay, now let's take a look at the leading coefficient of S to the 0. On the left side, I have 12. On the right side, I have 2 times 1, which is 2, negative 2, negative 2b. Okay? This one, 9, negative 9c. This one, 9 times 2, 18, negative 18d. This one, 9 times 2, 18, 18e. Okay? Now you know c, d, e, so you can find b easily. So let's just do some algebra. Let me use a calculator again. I get b equals negative 3 over 65. Okay? Make sure you check my math. Okay? Right now, I'm going to plug this back to here, okay? So I have capital Y of S equals, I'm going to write this out into two fractions. So I have AS over S squared plus 9 and A is equal to 3 over 130. So I have 3 over 130 times S plus B over S squared plus 9 and B is equal to negative 3 over 65 plus C over S plus 2 and C is equal to 16 over 39 plus D over S plus 1 and D is equal to negative 13 over 20 plus E over S minus 1. E is equal to 13 over 60. Okay, now apply the error bus on both sides. So on the left side, I get y of t equals on the right side, factor out 3 over 130. The Laplace transform of this s over s squared plus 9 is equal to cosine 3t. Okay, minus factor out 3 over 65. Or actually, factor out 1 over 65. Right? So this almost matches the side form, which is k over s squared plus k squared, and k is equal to 3, so we need to have the 3 on top, right? So I'm going to bring this 3 down here. So I have 3 over s squared plus 9, and that is psi of 3t. And its leading coefficient is just 1 over 65, okay? So 1 over negative 1 over 65 times psi 3t. For this one, factor out 16 over 39, error bus of 1 over s plus 2 is equal to e to the negative 2t. Factor out negative 13 over 20, then error bus of 1 over s plus 1 is equal to e to the negative t. Factor out 13 over 60, then error bus of 1 over s minus 1 is equal to e to the t. Okay, so this is your final answer eventually. That's it.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.